raised in the windy city of Chicago. And well, as long as I can remember, I pretty much thought outside of the box. Probably the tender age of about 22. I haven't had a traditional job since 22 years old. So, you know, my thoughts have always been, if you can show me at least one person who has experienced financial wealth working a job, then awesome. I'll do it your way. But if not, I gotta take a detour and do a little something different. So, to date, I won't really, I don't care if I'm telling you my age. But it's 22 times 20. I mean, 22 plus 20. Anyway, to date, I have not met anyone who has created financial wealth working a job. You know, needless to say, I went on, I experienced some phenomenal success in the real estate arena as a broker with Remax, and don't want to bore you guys because I spent out what happened in that arena within the last several years. So I started a travel agency, which was completely my passion, and, you know, specialized in groups and things of that nature. But what I soon found out was that though, you know, travel is fun and it's exciting, it is certainly not something that folks just have to do, especially in a nationwide recession. I am the first to tell you, and I'm almost embarrassed to tell you, when I was first presented with Vitel, I actually turned it down. I thought it was one of those cell phone things, and I had definitely been there, done that, bought the t-shirt even, and, you know, I was just in a space where, as far as I was concerned, I really didn't have the time to do it again. Needless to say, and, you know, I thank God for follow-up, because it's actually a pastor is my sponsor out of New York. And, you know, it took him, maybe he thought I was a crazy woman or something. It took him maybe a little over a month before he approached me again. But, you know, the second time, it's a charm, because it was just something about the conviction in his voice that made me say, you know what, let me stop what I'm doing. Let me just take a look. And really, you know, I'm a little sassy person. I really just say, hey, let me stop and take a look so I can tell you no again. That was my plan, but it didn't pan out that way. You know, after really looking at Vitel in its entirety, undeniably, I just had to, you know, to get involved in, you know, a little less than 4 months of being in the company. I got promoted to national sales executive, promoted now 3 other national sales executives under me, and, you know, life is great. So with that, let's go ahead and really get into the call. I would like to introduce to you guys our quiet storm, Miss Lydia Balash. She is actually the co-host of this call, and I just call her the mindset queen. I love, you know, just what she brings to the table in terms of mindset. And, you know, every time I talk to her, I kind of learn something different or find a different perspective or something. So, Lydia, I know you are out and about, and I'm just about to put you on the spot a little bit, but can you share, if it's not too crazy in your background, can you just introduce yourself and, you know, tell us a little about yourself and just why Vitel?
Good morning. Can you all hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you all hear me?
Yeah.
I have been fascinated with this industry, and when I found Vitel, I was looking for something in particular, and I am really impressed with the company. I had a list, and this was the one company that filled every criteria, and I have been impressed with the company since the day I joined. Our company is growing, going through a lot of changes, and I truly believe that we're going to be here for quite some time. Those of you are here, stay here. You're going to go through hardship. don't let anything or anyone dissuade you. Whatever the circumstances, whatever the obstacle, you deal with it and keep going. Hello?
Thank you, Miss Lydia.
Thank you so much, Lou. Sorry for all this background.
No, that's okay. And I'm really glad that you addressed that, because Vito is, we launched in 2010, and a lot of times, and just going with some adversities and changes, or whatever the case may be, some people look at change, and they just cannot function. Oh my God, they're changing this, they're changing that. But the thing about it is, and this is how you have to give yourself a gut check. If it's a brand new company, and it's only been around a couple of years, if there are absolutely no changes, run. Because that means they are doing a darn thing. You just kind of want it 3 years later to be in the same position, offering the same exact thing, the same exact way as you started. So I am here to tell you, I probably have a couple of us, we've been in for a year, we've pretty much seen it all and watched it grow, and you guys have no idea of what you have your hands on now. When I started Vitel, and it simply made sense, but guess what? We only had cell phones. We phone free, get yours free, 25 and draft. That's all we had. Now, not only do we have cell phones, we have our own cell phone, we're providing our own service, we're providing cable, internet. Providing energy. I mean, it just goes on and on, and we've moved into technology even. So we're on ahead of the curve, and I just love their concept, because with their concept, unlike a lot of other companies, because we are pretty much the middleman, just wheeling and dealing, making the deals and providing the actual savings to the customers, because we are the middleman, we can plug any product, any service into our equation and keep it moving and make a ton of money. So don't look at enhancements or changes or things that you don't understand. Don't look at it as a bad thing. I would be spooked. And here we sit, 3 years later, we haven't changed a darn thing. So, but one thing I can tell you, and I can just tell you from experience, because I've been around, every single enhancement that Vitel has made, my check has increased. So, I'm a cheerleader. Because the proof is in the pudding. I don't care what you say. If my checks are going up, you guys are on the right track. So with that, one of the main topics that I want to discuss today, it's just, this is really, it's going to be a little different, but it's really a call to action. Because we as women, I don't know if you know, but we make up over 80% of the direct sales industry as a whole. However, we're not in the higher percentage of the top money earners. To me, that is a problem. That's a problem. That means that we're allowing things to get in our way. Although it's like we're in the business, if we make up over 80% of the entire industry, we're here. Now, what are we doing? We don't just want to be a part of. We want to do more than that. I am so passionate about women stepping up to the plate and excelling. These men, they're going to make it. What's his name? Robert? Somebody's going to call. Close your gears, honey, for 1 second. Men are going to be all right. It's the women. A man can go and have 10 women and say, introduce you guys to a very special lady. She has just come into, you know, our business, blowing and going, I don't know what this woman is eating. I have no idea what she is eating, but, you know, in record time, has reached the position of ASM, and, you know, I just see her doing her thing and shining so brightly, very innovative, and I just want to just take a moment to, first of all, congratulate this young lady on her accomplishment to ASM, and then want to introduce to you guys one of our newest upcoming leaders. And I want you guys to hear from her. Miss Chanel Renee, are you in the building?
Absolutely.
Hi, folks. Hi, I can't even share with you. I want to just tell you, you know, I'm looking at you, and, you know, I just see myself all over again. Just hey, unstoppable. Unstoppable. I love your mindset, and I love what you're doing. Can you just share with us, like, first of all, you know, who you are, a little bit about where you come from, and why Vitel?
Absolutely. First, I have to say thank you for that amazing introduction. Lou, you are definitely a force to be reckoned with. If you didn't know, you need to. And I eat Wheaties. That's all I'm eating when I can. For everybody else, my name again is Chanel Renee Harmon. Everybody calls me Knight, actually, is my nickname. And I was born in Philadelphia by accident. My mom went to a wedding when my grandmother told her not to. But I was raised in Jersey. I am a Jersey girl through and through and through. I love Jersey. I grew up right here, just a regular girl. I love music. So most of my early childhood and early teens, I spent doing music. I wrote a lot of great songs back then that were hits. I've had some major successes in the music industry, as well as some major failures that kind of changed my life. And when the music publishing royalty check stopped coming, I realized, you know, in my early 20s, I'm fresh out of college and flat broke. I got involved in real estate on the corporate side. I've just always been ambitious. Every job I've ever had, from working at Dunkin' Donuts in college, I've always had to become the boss, because I just don't like feeling like someone is in charge of my dreams or even my pocket. So I've always been an entrepreneur in that sense of chasing that dream. I've never even really took a look at network marketing or this industry until a year ago. One of my best friends actually just invited me to his office to check out his new office. I was excited for him, and he just kind of caught me at the right day, because I knew, you know, my job was just terrible. I didn't want to be there. I'm still writing, but it's really hard to stay focused on that dream when you're broke. You have to eat, and I need to eat. I like to eat. So I went to check out the office. He did an amazing presentation. Both of them, actually, two of them, and I signed up right then and there without any money in my pocket. I didn't know where I was going to get it from, but I knew, I just felt in my heart like I need to do something else, because everything else that I'm doing is just not working. So with that being said, I just kind of, I went hard, and you know, you say you like my mindset. That's the work, because unless you're an employee, you're still in an employee mind state, and I wanted to do everything my own way. It was always follow the system. If you do it this way, you'll be successful. I felt that with my influence, especially in music, where I'm from, my neighborhood, my work history, everybody's going to just do this business because it's just me. It's Chanel. You can't tell me no. You love me. You love my shoes. You love my hair. You're getting in my business. No. It didn't happen like that at all. And I kind of felt flat a few times. And I'm like, okay. So now I have to learn to be coachable. And that was very hard for someone like me. I have such a strong personality, and I've always been about my business, and I didn't want to accept that I have to listen to someone else dwell in it. And eventually, you know, I really thank God that Cavalli and Lance had a lot of patience. You know, Lance especially was able to kind of just keep banging me in the head with ways to do it. And then I that with me. And this industry really reveals to you the kind of person you are. And if you're willing to endure, like Lydia said, those struggles or those downtimes and the times that you're not getting in check. So I started to change, and then I started to have some minor successes. The problem was, after a year, you know, who I know, we had this conversation, my residuals were looking like chump change. You know, I just lost my job, tired of my stuff, so now I'm really like, what am I going to do? And lo and behold, again, my best friend came to me, we did one-on-one actually, and the person was telling her about Vicel. He's like, no, we're not in Vicel. And they kept saying, they take your bills. He's like, what? So he researched it, came to tell me, and immediately, again, I was in a position where it's like, I really don't have this money to invest. I was fine with making investments, but I don't have the money to invest. I'm pretty much like my grandmother used to say, you rock either to pay Paul. And I did that, and we got involved, and we just hit the ground running as a team. Because, you know, together we all can achieve more. I know it sounds cliche, but really it's the truth. And I've just been trying my best to continue to inspire my team. And we chose myself because, honestly, exactly what you said, the compensation plan was undeniable. I was paid after a week in the business, and I've been in the business going on only 2 months, and I've made more in 2 months than I did a year in my prior company. That, to me, is ridiculous. So it's like, at this point, I'm married to myself. No one can tell me anything, and I know it's possible. I've seen it be possible, and we're just going to make it happen by any means necessary. So I just want to inspire anybody that's on this call. I understand what it is. Struggle. I still have struggles, but what I do see is the light at the end of the tunnel. If you can stay focused on one course to success, you can have it. Anything we dream, we can have, and those possibilities are endless. But again, it starts with you. How bad do you want it? And that's just where I'm at, Lou. I'm eating Wheaties at oatmeal. I'm in the gym at 5 o'clock in the morning. I'm 55 pounds down, so I feel like I want to not only financially, but my mind, body, and spirit, because I want to encourage other women, and we have to. That's why I really was happy when you called me. I was grabbing groceries, like I said, but I really want to inspire other women, because we have to be encouraging to each other, you know? And not a lot of times, you know, I found in corporate America, we're that way. It's very cutthroat. But being in this industry, and especially being new to myself, has been nothing short of a warm welcome. And the team, we're just trying to get it done. That's it, with no excuses. We're just trying to absolutely get it done.
Thank you so much.
Oh, that was beautiful.
The energy, and I'm not going to cry. I'm such a crybaby. Every time the mobile, I'm always crying. I'm not going to do that, but
sometimes.
That was beautiful. It's my first time actually hearing your story, so I thank you so much for sharing. Very, very powerful story. Very, very powerful story. And definitely thank you for sharing. Another young lady, I just have so much respect for her, and I have just seen her walk in a year, and just a total turnaround. I mean, just to emerge as a leader and start building, you know, a team, and, you know, to be looked up as a leader. And it is just amazing, you know, when you see people just blossom into the beautiful, beautiful butterfly. With that, so I do want to introduce to you guys, because a lot of times, like Chanel said, we do have struggles. How bad do you want it? So this next young lady that I want to introduce to you guys, some of you guys, most of you guys know her, some of you newcomers don't or have never heard her story. You know, I really just want to share with you guys, Miss Tiffany Kyle. Miss T, are you on the line?
I am, Miss Liz. Can you hear me okay?
I can, and that's with you, definitely, as an area sales manager. You are doing your thing. I love everything that you're doing, and but I know, you know, I've been around, I know it wasn't always easy. So can you share? It's a walk in the park. We just sign up and make $1 million tomorrow. So can you bless us with your story and then share, you know, your why buy deal?
Yes, I can. Thank you for calling me up. And wow, what a year it's been. I just celebrated my 1 year anniversary with the company, and that was on July the 3rd. And never in a million years did I even think I'd be here this long. Because I was skeptical. I thought, right, you're going to pay my bills. But really, that's the part that really drew me to Vitel, actually. Prior to getting started with Vitel, my husband and I had gone to college and earned our degrees, and my 2-year degree ended up taking me like almost 20 years, but that's okay, because I just kept changing my mind as life happened. Finally earned my bachelor's degree. My husband has a bachelor's degree. So we got careers. You know, back, you know, even say 20 years ago, getting a college degree and getting a career more or less made things secure for you. You could retire from it, you could build a 401k from it. You know, you didn't have to worry. Well, that's wrong. After being in a quote-unquote career for several years, 2008, when the economy started going south, my husband, he's a mechanical engineer, and he also served in the Marine Corps in Desert Storm, Desert Shield. He persevered through going to school because his whole family said that there's no way in heck he'd be able to finish it. But he did. He got a job for a company doing what his profession is, mechanical engineering, and he also had a minor in industrial engineering. So he designed all of the guts, you would say, of a business. Well, a home, plumbing, electrical. So he did very well, and then he opened up his own business at the same time. I went to work as an accountant, and I worked for a CPA firm, which I felt, and I chose that career because everybody needs a CPA. But I had a specialty. My specialty was accounting with nonprofit organizations. As we all know, nonprofits run off of grant money, state and federal grant money. 5 years ago, my husband got laid off, and the business that he owned, all of a sudden, people weren't paying him. 4 months after he got laid off, I was laid off. Believe it or not, on April the 9th, which is just shy of about 5-6 days from tax day, I got laid off because nonprofit organizations run on grant money, and when the federal government started cutting all of that off, these organizations, they had to shut down because they can't operate. When I was told that, and given my last paycheck, and it was kind of, I had no idea that this was happening, I cried. I didn't want to come home and tell my husband, well, guess what, now you both don't have a job. But I came home, and it was like the end of the world to us. We had no idea what we were going to do. We both went on unemployment, and we were receiving our unemployment checks, which didn't even cover the bills that we had every single month. We also had 8 children. My husband brought 2 into the marriage. He'd been married previously. I brought 3 into the marriage, and then we're also raising my brother's 3 children. And panic set in. We still searched for jobs, and there was nothing in our field. We'd each have to go get a couple part-time jobs, 2 or 3 each, that wasn't going to work, because then that would have to require us working nights, and we couldn't do that youngest set of children we had is a set of six-year-old twins. 99 weeks went by, no job. That 99th week came, and we received our last unemployment check. Talk about panic. I didn't know what we were going to do. We had basically used up every time we had in our savings. We had about $200 left in savings. There was nothing besides some child support that I was getting for my son from previous marriage. And we were faced with some of the most incredible struggles that I've ever seen. I mean, I've never been a part of that. I've always had a job and money. I mean, we weren't wealthy, but we could pay the bills. We actually had to go on welfare. And it was one of the hardest things we ever had to do. My husband was so embarrassed. He didn't want to go. Well, if he didn't go with me, we couldn't apply because it had to be both of us that go and apply for it. We go and apply for welfare. We feel like we're scum. Feel like we're not worthy of anything, and the self-esteem could be on bottom. So what did we end up getting? We ended up getting a cash aid, food stamps, and we got state medical insurance for all the kids. My husband and I didn't qualify for medical insurance, believe it or not. Good thing my husband had the VA because he's always got insurance. That was, I have asthma. That wasn't a good thing for me because I take medication called maintenance medication. So now I had to out-of-pocket pay for medications that don't even have a generic form yet. We did that. All of a sudden, a friend of mine had contacted me about a company named Vitel. And I said, okay, well, where's their office so I can go and apply for a job? Well, it's not that. It's a home-based business, and I said, okay, I've been there, done that. Those don't work. She said, no, but this is a little bit different, and I know the kind of situation you're in, and I really want you to take a good look at it. And I said, okay, what is it? And she goes, well, I need you to come to a webinar. And I said, I don't want to sit through a webinar. Just tell me what it is. I was already in a bad mood because I wasn't able to support my family, let alone my children. And she said, trust me, just come. Okay. I went and I sat in on my very first Vitel presentation. I believe it was with randomized. And, you know, I sat there and I listened and I said, when he got to the part that said, well, Vitel's going to help you pay your bills. And I'm like, say what? I'm like, okay, I'm listening. So then they, you know, talked about the bills that they were going to pay. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I have all of those. Someone's going to help me pay them? Oh my gosh, this could really help. I became a rep with Vitel, and it was $100 to join. I came in as platinum. Well, I was given all kinds of training. I was told to get on webinars, I was told to get on training sessions, I was given a team website, kind of shown how to do this. I was fairly new to Facebook, but I kind of knew how to do things on Facebook. So I just kind of watched people for a while. The first 2 weeks, I did absolutely nothing. I paid for it and did absolutely nothing. I was in the biggest city party he'd ever seen. So then I started throwing my link out there. Say anything else, but said, you have to see this, and I put my link. And then I got irritated, no, pissed off, because nobody was going to my link, nobody was signing up, why not? So, I wanted to quit. And I told my sponsor, you know what, this is just not working, I have to find me a real job. And she said, what are you doing? And I said, well, I'm putting my link out there. She goes, okay, so did you do all the things I asked you to do? Well, no, I didn't really have time. She goes, you don't have time. You don't have no job. What Well, why would they? How do they know what the heck that is? And I said, oh, good point. So, how many webinars have you been on since you signed up? And I said, none. Why should I get on the same thing? Because I already know what it is. It's the same webinar I saw when I signed up. She said, well, because it's called plugging into the system. I said, what the heck is that? And then she told me. But see, I still have this pitch poor attitude and a pity party going on. And so I went to the webinar and I sat through it and I'm like, okay, I get a hold of her on the phone. I said, so what's changed? Nothing since when I signed up. I get it. She said, that's not the point. And I said, okay. She said, so go to the next one. And I'm like, seriously? She said, yeah, seriously. I'm going to be there and I'll make sure you're on there. And I said, all right. So I went to the next one. And then it was like the exact same webinar. And I said, okay. So I'm listening. Well, then I picked up some information that I didn't hear the first or second time. I said, oh, well, maybe I'm doing this a little bit wrong. So I told her, she goes, very good. Now go to the next one. I said, are you kidding me? She said, no, I'm not. It's called being plugged in. By the way, I haven't seen you welcome anybody in the Facebook group. And I'm like, welcome them in. And she said, yeah, go check out the group. And I said, all righty. And I see all these posts in there. Then I find my post where she welcomed me in, and there's all these people that said welcome to the family. So I said, oh, okay. So I thought she might just respond to the people that were responding to welcoming me in. And then I started talking back and forth with them, and I said, well, how do you do this? And they said, well, did you go to the train site? And I said, no. Why can't you just tell me? She goes, because it doesn't work that way. You need to pay attention. And then she said to me, you know what, maybe this really isn't for you. Then I got mad. So, well, that was the first month, and I didn't put one person in, wasted my $100 or so, I thought. Second month, I said, okay, well, I got another $100 left in savings, I'm going to give it one more shot. Because we didn't have a choice. We had to make some money, and I cried because I don't know what the heck I'm doing wrong. Why isn't this working? I see it working for everybody else. So I used the last $100 we had and it changed things up a bit, got a little bit more response from people, but so completely frustrated, I said, that's it, I'm quitting. She said, well, this is the fourth time you've told me that, so maybe this really isn't for you. It's not for everybody. And that made me mad, so I went back and started doing some more work. Because I don't like people telling me I can't do something. So I went to a training. Wow, I'd already been in the company over a month and never gone to a training. It was a mastermind by Brandon Ivy. And some of the things he said, I was like, whoa, how did you know what's going on in my mind? And then, I mean, there was on that webinar. I'm like, seriously? All you people come and listen to this every single week? Well, I listened to it the second week. And things started clicking in my mind that I'm really doing something wrong, but I really don't know what. So I wanted to quit again. She said, okay, it's not for everybody. I said, that's it. I'm calling up Brandon Ivy. I don't care if he's an RVP, but if he's doing something right and I'm doing something wrong, I'm going to find out what's going on. So I call up Mr. Brandon Ivy, and I told him who I was, and I said, I have to make this work. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. He said to me, well, it's not for everybody. And I said, why do you people keep saying that to me? And he said, because sometimes it's things that we have to tell you that you don't want to hear. And I said, okay, so I'm listening. And he said, I want you to go find 5 Jim Rohn videos on YouTube and watch all 5, come back and tell me what you found out from this one universal message. Okay, so I go to YouTube. I had no idea who the heck this Jim Rohn character was. And he has a gazillion videos out there.
So I'm starting to take some. I'm like, oh my gosh, some of them are over an hour long. Are you serious? But I listened. I took notes. Well, I couldn't pinpoint one single message. I had a lot of things, but not one single message that every one of them produced. Called them back, and I said, I don't know. Here's what I've done. He goes, nope. We'll watch five more. Call me back. And I'm thinking, you know what? I really can't deal with these bozos. Keep telling me to do all this stuff, and I can't. Nothing's happening. Listen to five more. It finally clicked what he was getting at. I called him back. I was so excited because for once in, you know, 2 months of being in Vital, I figured out what I was doing wrong. I told him, and he said, okay, what have you found? And I said, you have to work harder on yourself than you do your business. And he said, you got it. Now go to work. I'm like, well, great. Now, what does that mean? So I did that. I reached out. Actually, my sponsor ended up leaving the company. I didn't know who I could go to. But what I knew was I wanted to be able to support my family. I didn't have a choice. I needed this as much as I needed to breathe. So I reached out to Lou Smith, who, another benefit for me, but I reached out to her because I saw what she was capable of doing and how she was leading it. I wanted to be Lou Smith. I reached out to Brandon Ivy. I reached out to Dr. Michael Smith. And they took me under their wing and taught me. From that point on, I've been unstoppable. I ran into so many speed bumps and roadblocks. I wanted to quit 6 times. And I didn't. I produced 4 area sales managers. I've got 5 more that are right on the cusp of being promoted to ASM. 14 team leaders that are now working their way up to ASM. Never in a million years did I think this would work. I did not put my first person into the company until October. But something interesting happened to me. In September, I didn't have the money to pay for my next month's marketing agency, but I wasn't ready to give up yet. Me and my children went door to door collecting aluminum cans until we had enough money to cover my $100. My husband said, "You did what?" And I said, "Yeah, honey, this is what I did." At that point, my husband said, "I'm sorry. I am not supporting you in this anymore. Get out of this thing you're doing." My husband and I fought. Lou Smith knows this because I called her crying one night and said that I have to make a choice between this business and my husband. And she said, well, that's common. You need to work on that, but you have to do what you need to do. Okay? Step back a little bit from what you're doing. I didn't have that option. I still had no job. So I started talking to my husband about it, and I said, please, just give me this one more month. Because if you don't bring anybody in, then you're done. So I'm like, okay, no pressure. Well, I brought my first person into the company on October 12th, and I was so excited. It was an agent. But I didn't care, because it did something. It gave me confidence and I could do it. And from then on, from my 6 month on, I had been earning fast start bonus money. I was started getting my bills paid. By the time I was 6 months into the company, I had 4 bills paid on a monthly basis. By the time I was 7 months into the company, I had 5 bills paid on a monthly basis. And for the last 3 months, I've had 6 bills paid. That means I'm getting that $750 cash bonus a month now. And not only on the same month that I got that, I helped another person in my organization get it the same month I got it. And, I mean, I owe everything to this company. Yes, there's been change, and I've endured it 3 times. Was it easy? No. Change is not easy. But you persevere. Have I cried because I felt like I kept losing people?
Mm-hmm.
I sure did. I rebuilt. I'm teaching my whole organization to do that too. Do I have the same people when I first started still with me? Nope. I rebuilt. I absolutely love what I do. And I couldn't imagine doing anything else. And I'm trying to teach people who maybe were in my same boat situation. Going there, heading there, is there, or been there. So they don't have to ever be where we were. That's my story. And I'm sticking to it.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, Miss Kitty. Oh my God. Sometimes we have our breakthroughs, sometimes so that we can help each other in excelling. A couple of things that I want to, Melissa, thank you so much, Miss Penny, for sharing. Awesome. We recently, 2 weeks ago, I don't know if all of you guys know, but we launched our Vital Energy Division with Kona Energy. Lucky for us, and not too long ago, we partnered with Greens Investment Fund. And for those of you who don't know, they are a lead investment firm. And what they do pretty much is they take a small company, you know, they might take a $2 to $5 million company, and within 2 to 5 years, they turn it into, you know, $100 million, $200 million company. This is what they do. They've done it time and time and time again. They own the Cleveland Browns. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with the restaurant chain of Five Guys, with the hamburgers. They own, in addition to all the other investments and things of that nature, they actually own 2 energy companies. So we're pretty sad. It's very hard to kind of tap into the industry market. Now, when you do, typically there's a lot of red tape. But because now we are a partner with them and they own it, just say no more red tape. And so we're very, very excited about that. We can move forward. We're actually, our initial 4 states are Illinois, Ohio, New York, and Texas. And here's the key. If you don't know anybody, I mean, if you are not in one of those 4 states, it doesn't mean that you can't start strategically, you know, trying to get business partners in those states. You can still, you know, with the World Wide Web and how it is today, we can target any geographic area we choose to, you know, as far as just building a team there. I know my largest team, I'm from Chicago, but my largest team is in Jersey. You know, that's kind of crazy. I got almost 200 reps in Jersey. So, you know, that's my largest team. I'm in Chicago. So I just want to give you guys that. And you want to start now. Don't say, well, you know, it's not regulated in my state, so I can't capitalize on it. Sure you can. You build a team of at least 4, and as we open up, you expand. Absolutely. Another thing I want to bring to your attention, we are totally, we have changed our weekly PTM schedule. Now, we're only going to have live webinars, and I'm looking in the back office. I mean, I'm looking at the schedule now. It will be changed. Actually, all of our webinars will take place at liveonedream.info. I thought this was updated. It's not. It still has the broadcast.com. So we're going to be at liveonedream.info for everything we do, excluding the Spanish stuff. They have a different link. But anything else, PTM, we're going to be at liveonedream.info. And our presentations, our webinar presentations, business presentations, are going to be held on Thursday, and Sunday at 9 p.m. Eastern. And then we will have trainings to follow, and our trainings start at 10 p.m. We found it better to have the trainings follow the live webinar so that those who are new, you know, straight into, you know, some type of training. Now, on Monday night, our team, Policy Monday, we're taking it into a whole different year. This is really our season and our time. You know, we've done a lot of enhancing, and we are just ready to blow this thing out of the park. Now, there are some new things that are coming we're about to launch. I won't share everything with you. I won't do it. But I can tell you, it won't mean a you guys don't get busy right now. It's all about building your foundation. And how you do that, we kind of get back to three ways. I don't know what it is about three ways that are scary. We have got to get to the three ways. And if you follow the system, it's so easy to get to the three way. We kind of stop winging it. In corporate America, we wing it. In network marketing, we are a team, and together everyone achieves more. And it's all about changing your mindset. See, we were so taught not to copy. You know, if we copied and back off, we would get in trouble. In network marketing, it is perfect. A lot of it okay to copy. We encourage it. We encourage it. The best copycat wins also. So there's enough for everybody. You don't have to be the innovative one. You don't have to be the one to think of it first. Copy and get paid. Guess what you say? Who cares? Who thought of it? But we have a system that is in place, and we have to embrace the system. It is like if somebody shows you a blueprint of how to get from point A to Z. There's a pot of gold at Z. Why? What, you going to throw the blueprint away and say, that's okay, I'm going to figure it out? It sounds silly, just put it, but that's what most of us do because we've been trained to, you know, I see what y'all are doing, but see, I'm going to do it this way. You've been doing it this way for however long, how many ever years you've been working at your job. It's not working. So follow the blueprint. I'm not saying that once you follow the blueprint, once you master that and that is working, of course you can start tweaking and incorporating a little bit of this and a little bit of that. You know. Well, and I always said, why would you mess up a perfectly good pot of gumbo? Why would you screw that up? As expensive as gumbo is for the ingredients, why in the world would you mess it up? And so that's what we do when we try to do our own thing before we master the basics. Because when you master the basics, you can go anywhere and be a success. But, you know, I look on, you know, even Facebook, and it just kind of breaks my heart to see people just bounce, and I feel like a jackrabbit. Bounce. Every little new shiny object. They're gone and off again. But the problem with that, you don't allow yourself to build a foundation. You cannot build a house on sand. It's impossible. Okay, you can build it on sand. However, it's not going to stand. So you can waste your time and build it on sand if you want. But as soon as the water hits the shore, trust me, it's a wrap. So, with that, let's go back to what works. I don't care what network marketing company you've ever been a part of, all of them tell you to do three ways. They're not saying that because it doesn't work. They're saying it because that's the close. That's the close. So right now, we're telling you, you have a three-step process. That's what happens if you do step one, step two. Step one, step two. If you never get to step three, which is the three-way call, the close, how many people or how effective do you think you're going to be in closing people into your business if you never even get to the close? Now, another thing is, if step three is the close, then how quickly should you try to get there and how often? We cannot be afraid of the three-way.
I hear people say, Lou, I've tried everything.
For travel.
clients to just jump on that. So please get that out there, create the value. And lastly, the last thing I really want to talk about is in terms of leadership, we are taking this thing to a whole nother level, like I said. As soon as we come back from our leadership summit in Houston on August the 9th and 10th, Power Team Marketing was establishing a leadership, it's an elite mastermind group. Because what we understand, what we don't want to do is stagnate the people who want to run. The beauty about network marketing is, you know, everybody's an independent representative. We all get a chance to really work at our own paces. And it's nothing wrong with that. If you want to crawl, crawl. Just keep crawling. If you want to walk, walk. No problem. Just keep walking. If you want to run, then we have to provide a platform for you to run. You know? And we can't really keep the crawlers and the runners in the same space because we stagnate the runners. So with that, we're creating our very own elite mastermind group. And what it's going to be, because it's not for everybody. Now we're explaining, you know, we're well aware that it's not for everybody, and that is fine. That's okay. You know, however you want to build, you know, it's on you. But specifically for the runners. However, what we will do is give everybody an opportunity to participate. So we're going to start on a very level playing field, and we're going to open it up to everybody. And the initial prerequisite, and then as you go, there's going to be some accountability. There's going to be some accountability. There's going to be some, challenges that we put out there. There's going to be a whole lot of things just to help you stretch yourself. So we're going to start out with a level playing field. Everybody can participate. Yes, the prerequisite is you have to maintain your own personal bisocial and DBS. That's the first thing. So if anybody on this line who is maintaining both their bisocial and their VBN, you guys can email me if you want to be a part of this elite mastermind group. And like I said, this is the first thing. But from there, it's just going to get, we're going to challenge you more and more because we just got to run. We can't play with this thing. So, you know, it's not for everybody, but if you want to run, and I'm not saying you got to be, I don't care what kind of skill set you have right now. It's not about that. You come if you want it. This is for the people who want it. It doesn't matter what you currently have going on. I'm just specifically talking about your burning desire. Everything else you guys are going to learn along the way. Okay? But it is an accelerated program where we're going to, you know, be teaching you some things to help you just to explode your business. You know, it's time to get into the real residuals in a very short amount of time. So with that, my email address, if you are maintaining your bisocial and your VBN at this time, you are welcome into the group. Go ahead and send me an email at louweezebra@yahoo.com. So louweez2@yahoo.com. In the subject, as an ASM or an NSC even or RSM. So in order for you to take it to the next level, you know, when I got into Vitel, I wasn't really looking at what it was then. Like I said, we only had cell phones, you know, refer three. Get my cell phone bill paid free, and then refer 25 and grab. That's all we had. So all those other stuff is extra, and, you know. But what I did see, I got it through Vitel for the vision of where they were going, you know, to be the Walmart of network marketing, to be able to plug in a central products and services that people already have, they already need, they already refuse to get rid of. You know, and then I could get paid in that stream. Are you kidding me? And so I got in because of the vision of where we were going. And, you know, I'm so glad, you know, over a little over a year today, so glad that I could just see the vision. But sometimes it's not right. It's not all of the time, if you really want to know. It's not about right now. It's not even about you. To be honest, it's not even about you. I cannot wait until people get a year from now. Do you know? I mean, it just makes sense to you guys, right? Our concept is just awesome. It's probably the most awesome concept in the industry right now. And with everything that is coming, people are going to start to go Vitel bananas. And if you do not establish your foundation right now, your platform right now, a year from now, everything growing and going could be in your organization. It's not about you. Do you think the person who sponsored Brandon, who sponsored that person before him, do you think they had a clue that Brandon Ivy would show up in their downline? You know, a loose lip, a penny cow. Do you think that their equine? That's really not. So it's really not about us. It really isn't. I cannot wait for people to get in this business who are so much more than me. Please, I can't wait for you to knock me out of the ballpark. You know, it doesn't matter. I override everything they do, right? I'll tell anybody, I am not the sharpest tool in the shed. I'm just smart enough. I'm not the sharpest. I'm just smart enough to be positioned. And that's good enough to me. And so with that, I'm not going to hold you guys. There is a training tonight. Tonight is going to change your life. There is a very important training tonight. It's going to be hosted by our Brandon Ivy, 10 p.m. Eastern. It's going to be at live1dream.info. Please make sure that your entire team is on this training. Registered. Tonight is going to be the night. you know, there's some things that are going to change. It's going to be a change. It's going to be a God will learn today. So tonight is going to be the night, 10 p.m. Eastern. Make sure you have your entire team on the training. And with that, if nobody has anything else to share, then we can definitely conclude the call. I thank you, ladies, for being here.
Great call.
You guys have a good weekend.
You all have a wonderful weekend. Talk to you all later.
Bye-bye.
Hello.
Bye-bye.
Bye, everybody.
Goodbye.